City of beats, city of development, city possessing beauty of heritage, known as hub for best education and entitled to be the second best city for business destination in whole of Karnataka. Declining a little from the lavish exposure of our coastal city, there lies a concealed face of it.
Materialistic joy is not only the kind of happiness that prevails. This pure expression of happiness is what occulted by a greedy society. We call them dirty slum folks. We use their names to vent, angrily swear at people. Why? Because they are deprived. Forget luxury, but of necessity. This is what their house be like. No longing for duplex, no longing for spacious, crafted, fine furniture, nothing. In fact, it's just a small room with no division of rooms, but just one small space for entire family. They eat, sleep, change, talk, study, cook, play, laugh, talk, everything that an individual's day doing revolves inside this four paper walls.
The scarcity to blow out the heat to temperature that causes constant sweat rolling all through their body all through the day is indeed a bizarre experience a person in Mangalore can ever imagine. But this is how their dawn to dusk always be like. They have no option left but where to survive.
Can you imagine a Sunday lunch without a slice of meat in your meal? Nor an aromatic vegan kurma? No. But their breakfast, lunch and dinner, if only days are lucky enough for them to have it all, it's just the hard roti and a dilute cereal syrup. And those who make this are the lovely ladies of the house whose entire day is a sweat out. It's the morning rays at 4 a.m. dawn, followed by a long walk to fetch the total of 10 buckets of water per family. And then later, it's the engagement with cavitated vessels and hand-broken ladles in the kitchen. And the kitchen is just about 5 hand span in total area. ಎಷ್ಟು ಗಂಟೆ ತನಕ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಈಗ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 4 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಹೋದಾರ ಈಗ
ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಂಬಳ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ?
ಸಂಬಳ 600, 700, 500
ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ ಅಲ್ಲ ಮನೇಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ.
The ladies set out to earn their little daily wages, which contributes to their little extra happiness, which may be in the form of a singed samosa bites, which is just for ₹5 that this man sells on a weekend. Man of the house too has full of his contribution towards making their day possible. It's the men with no sight of educational institution at all, other than dropping their children to the school allotted for them by the aid of government.
ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಸರ್. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೆಸರು? ಸಾರಿ ಸರ್,
ಗಿರಿಯಾಪುರ.
ಗಿರಿಯಾಪುರ. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಸರ್?
ಗಾರೆ ಕೆಲಸ.
ಗಾರೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಲೈಕ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೇಂಟಿಂಗ್? ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಾಡಿ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಡುದು. ಓಕೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳು. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ ಅವರು?
ಶಾಲೆ.
ಯಾವ್ದು ಶಾಲೆ?
ಮನೆ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ.
ಮನೆ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕಲಿತಾ ಇದಾರೆ?
ಏಳನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್.
ನೀವ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಸರ್?
ಶಾಲೆ ಹೋಗಲಿಲ್ಲ
ಮೇಡಮ್. ಓಕೆ ಸರ್. ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇರುವವರ?
ಊರೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಆಯ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿ
ಹದಿನೈದು
ವರ್ಷ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್
The government has facilitated them with a solar electricity that is reflected in their single bulb, which is the only solution that the children seek for their homeworks and tests next day. These bunch of friends spend their day in government-aided school nearby. They are provided with uniform, midday meal and initial formal schooling till 10th grade. They come back and play with Mary and ignorant to the reality of life's pulsating hardship. And this play area is these unhygienic atmospheres with flies all over from the uncleaned excretion neighboring their play area. Their resident area has an out edge of guttered water body where the sanitary napkins are disposed, and this holds their landmark. Their washrooms are with no proper ceiling and no proper discharge of waste facilities.
ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಹೊರಗೆ ಎಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಮಂತ್ಲಿ ಮಂತ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಲೈಕ್ ಬಟ್ಟೆನ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಟೇ ಫ್ರೀ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಪ್ಯಾಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಸಾಡುದು ತೋಡಿಗೆ ಹಾಕುದಾ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
These are infants like those in our neighborhood, youngsters like our family, adults like our parents. Why are we discriminating and depriving them of then? Because they are residents of so-called slum? It's time for us to broaden our mindset towards the special migrants of our society. It's not that we isolate them, but help them have a platform to grow just like us. We surely will have better motherland citizens.